Hey everybody, this is Michael Cohen, the Tech Rabbi, and welcome back to another video in our series focusing on Microsoft OneNote. We are going to talk today about the collaborative power of Microsoft OneNote, ways that you can collaborate with your colleagues, ways that students can collaborate with each other, and just to maximize that power of collaboration. So let's get going.
So when you're in Microsoft OneNote, being able to share and collaborate in an effective way is one of the things that makes this app so powerful. So there's a couple of different strategies that I use. So when I'm working with a co-teacher, working with someone on content, project creation, so we share notebooks and we're able to live see the content as we create it. And the other way that I like to use it is even just with my own notebooks, but across different devices. So I did a screen recording for one of these videos in the series, and I was able, instead of sending it an email or uploading it to cloud storage, I was able to upload it directly into OneNote, and then I'm able to access it by just opening up the hyperlink, and I'm able to see that content, I'm able to download it, share it, etc. But it's just a really effective way of sharing and making sure that everything is where it should be. I have a whole series of different PowerPoint and Word documents that need to be quickly accessible. And I just feel like it's all about the context here. Yes, you can have it in cloud storage and it can be accessed and organized that way. But when I think about resources that I need for this course and I want myself and my students to have it, I want to be able to get those as soon as possible, not go try to find them in some sort of subfolder somewhere in my cloud storage, assuming that it was that organized. So that is, I think, a couple different ways that collaboration and sharing you're super powerful. Hope you enjoyed this video and stay tuned for the other videos in this series on what makes OneNote so awesome.